Hi, this is Jamie Davis, the Podmedic. We're here at the IRCP conference. That's the International Roundtable for Community Paramedicine. I'm here with Lisa Ward, who is the Community Paramedicine Coordinator for Western Eagle County Ambulance District. And yeah, got it right on the first try. And this is a brand new job for her. And so I'm going to find out a little bit about what this job, you expect this job to mean to you, and a little bit about community paramedicine in Western Eagle County. So I'll start off with, what do you expect this job to do in the near term? Because it's a brand new job. You're just starting out. So you're exploring some things.
I am exploring some things. It is a new job as of yesterday. So I've been on the job for exactly 2 days. So it's new to me as well. But the program is new. It's a new innovative program for Western Eagle County Ambulance District. I come to Western Eagle County Ambulance District with a background in state health. I worked previously for the EMS and trauma section for the state health department in Colorado. I ran the EMS for children program there. So I have a background in state health, public health, and I've worked as an EMT for 12 years in emergency departments across the state of Colorado. So I will be coming on board to help the paramedicine community project in helping to collaborate with PCPs, primary care physicians. I will be the link between Western Eagle County Ambulance District and the constituents and the public. So I'll be working with primary care physicians, stakeholders, constituents, advisory committees. I'll be doing a lot of work with the grants. I have a background in grant writing and grant budget, so I'll be working with the grants, writing some new grants. It is a part-time position as of now. We're kind of taking some baby steps toward the staff and the program, which will be moved into full-time pretty quickly. But it's an exciting new program for Western Eagle County. It has the potential to be a national model for community paramedicine, and I'm honored and excited to be a part of it.
It's a very exciting program that's being instituted here. I think there are, three or four paramedics that have now are preparing to graduate or have already graduated from the initial curriculum?
Yes. So they had a program, I believe it was in January, that they graduated some paramedics for WECAD out of that program. The way that Western Eagle County Ambulance District is setting up the program right now, they're actually allowing paramedics to volunteer to be a community paramedic. So the chief of the Western Eagle County Ambulance District is not forcing any of the paramedics to participate in the program if they don't want to. It's on a strictly voluntary basis right now, which is a great opportunity for people who really want to be involved to be involved. So right now we have several paramedics who have volunteered to be in the program. They've gone through the educational aspect of it. Right now we're still working on some scope of practice things. We met with the state health director last week to discuss some of the scope of practice things that the community paramedics will be doing in the home healthcare setting.
And is there any particular initiative you're trying to kick off with as far as what particular skills they're going to be bringing to the community and what are they doing, more assessment or public health outreach?
They're doing a variety of different things. So everything from well baby checks to blood pressure checks, going into the home and ensuring that people are being compliant with their medications. If they're not being compliant with their medications, why is that? Is it because they don't like the side effects? They're making them sick? They're not clear on the instructions? They're doing some wound care, post-op care. So basically, the community paramedic works directly and collaboratively with the primary care physician. So if the primary care physician, for instance, needs a blood draw after a surgical procedure, the community paramedic can go out into the home, draw the blood, take it back to the lab to the doctor, and that saves that patient the transportation costs and the cost of going into the doctor's office. It's convenient. It uses the paramedic in a great way to help the community. They can do preventative care, such as going to a geriatric home, and when the community paramedic is in the home, they can evaluate, kind of look around the home and see if there's uneven floors, they don't have rails on their bathtub. These are things that they can report back to the primary care physician, and the primary care physician can order things like that. And then they actually have an opportunity to call the fire department, who can also come out to help install those kind of things. So that decreases the risk of a fall risk for a geriatric patient. And all that's while you're checking on your patient. Are they compliant with their meds? Or they're taking their blood pressure. So there's several several areas that in the scope of practice that the community paramedic can do.
Excellent. Well, I know that a lot of people are really following what's going on with this particular initiative in Western Eagle County Ambulance District, and we may be back talking with you in another time in the future to see how this program has evolved, because it really is going to change as you identify what's working and what's not working.
Yeah, it's great. We'd love to have you anytime.
Great. Thanks a lot.